you know, investment, you know, and real estate, of course.
Or what is it going to invest on real estate?
Place to place.
Case to case.
If you're going to buy a real estate that's not earning, and you're just hoping the price will go up, forget it.
So what is a good real estate?
Meron nagja-jackpot sa ganun, ha?
Meron.
Well, I'm talking about the majority. It's not, it's speculation yun eh. That's not investment.
Ah,
that's
okay.
Speculation. But if you go into real estate with an earning asset, and it's earning, let's say, 8% per year on rental, and tansya mo mag-increase yung value ng property,
correct.
Generally, it's good.
Because we are always...
Nakalabang mo lang doon vacancy.
I know. Because we're always told na, no, you can buy land. Kasi hindi yan nagbumababa ang presyo. Instead of, ano, yan na lang ang bilhin mo. That makes sense.
Meron din bumababa.
May bumababa din.
Sa Amerika ngayon, nagbababaan.
Oh, may bumababa din.
It's important to have earning assets. All the time.
All the time. So kung
it's better than, you know, minsan you go for absolute value return instead of percentage.
Topax, there's another thing about Pinoys, and this includes me and a lot of my friends. We're very emotional about our properties. We're very emotional about our properties. I don't want to sell this piece of land, or I don't want to sell my rest house because it's part of me. It's part of my journey. It's part of my story. Pero hindi ko naman nadadala. I'm not complaining about my rest house.
Sabi nga mag-asawa. Anything we don't need, we dispose of.
How do you do that? Hindi kayo nasasaktan? Don't you manage your feelings and your emotions?
Because we want to enjoy our life, share it with our children and people. So, ano nangyayari kasi pag ang dahi-dahi mong properties, hindi ka na nakakabisita na ibang lugar.
Naku, totoo yun.
Kasi kailangan mo bisitahin yun, sayang ang investment mo eh.
So,
I'd like to see the world. I'd like to see other places.
So, it is wise actually to dispose of properties that you do not need.
Yes.
E paano yung emosyon?
Ay, kanya-kanya solution yan. I don't know.
But you understand that, no?
Yeah,
have you heard a lot of problems na
dyan,
hindi
gusto
ko mabitawan dahil mahal ko at iniwanan sa akin ng tatay?
Oo, yun.
Yung may mga sentimental values.
Kasi yun, yung mga ganun, nagagawa nila dahil they have other sources of income.
Alright.
But
okay.
For those who need it, they have to go. Ang problema naman doon, they dispose it of it at the wrong time and they get the wrong price.
I got that advice from a friend, actually. Stop your attachment. You know, this attachment with your properties. Especially
I know of a family na yung kanilang parents, they're sharing everything with their children, cash basis. Nobody gets to inherit this lot or this property. When I die, sabi nung, everything has to be converted to cash. Share.
That's practical.
Practical, wala
that's practical. Ano. Okay.
Yun ang bumula ang...
After all these books, how rich are you?
Enough lang naman. You know, the money we earn on these books goes to our small foundation.
I know.
And I really don't earn money on these things for myself. For developing the organization and doing more things. My wife and I are very simple lang naman lifestyle namin.
No, but
I really appreciate it. It's easy in this country to earn, to live comfortably.
That's true. Before this conversation, actually, we were saying, how do we introduce Mr. Colaico? And really funny, because, you know, you're an author, you wrote books, and you're a financial advisor, you're an entrepreneur, etc. But, you know, somebody said, you know, he's actually essentially a nationalist. Really,
well,
because you're helping a lot of people, you're touching people's lives, you're very honest, you're very practical. For example, in one of your books, you discuss that when you do something, you have to get paid.
Yes.
You know, we are shy about it.
Mali yun eh.
Totoo.
Mali.
Yung, magkano ba ang bayad na?
Wala. Because learning does not take place if you don't get hurt. It does not take place. Yung mga seminars na nakikita ko offered by some agencies, free, everybody come. They send the reports to their mother, head office, and say, oh, we spent 2 million for training, 2,000 attended. And how many learned?
That's true.
Pero kami, we charge a little to cover the cost. But nobody stands up in 5 to 6 hours. Nobody. There's no food, there's no water. But they all listen. And because I'd rather have quality audience, committed audience.
Than quantity. That's true. Okay.
That's why we said, you know, sabi nga nila sa economics, there's no free lunch.
Wala talaga.
Wala talaga sa mundong ito. You pay for it one way or the other.
And I like that. I mean, you learn well for lack of a better word, when there is pain involved.
Hmm.
That's true. But what is the most important lesson in this second book?
It's getting it to start.
Which is the hardest part?
Getting started.
Diba? Getting started.
Kasi you're made aware, now you know what you have to do. You accept your responsibility. How do I start? That's why in that book, I start with invest in debt.
Explain that.
Pay your debt.
Pay your debt.
Most of us are up to our necks in debt. So why? Because we bought so many things we didn't need. So that's why I would say, if you know your assets and liabilities, you know what assets you can convert to cash, put down that debt, throw down that debt, because that will release cash for you that you can use to grow your wealth.
That's why you discuss comprehensively in this book yung statements of assets and liabilities. Para alam mo kung saan ka talaga nakatayo.
My favorite question na in my seminar, the first question I ask is, how many are married? Oh, tata sila. Okay, what's the first question or statement you make to your spouse when you wake up? I have a suggestion. No? Bulong nyo sa asawa nyo. Honey, magkano ka ngayon?
Ganda nun, ha?
Magkano ka ngayon? We have to know more or less what we are worth every 8 o'clock.
Every 8 o'clock in the morning? I'll do that starting tomorrow.
Honey, more or less.
Honey, magkano ka ngayong umaga? No, but I see the point.
Because if you don't know where you are,
but you have to make sure you're talking to the same honey every morning. Kasi baka mag-iba-iba ang sagot.
Marami kang balance sheet. Mahihilapan ka nun.
Another thing, I mean, everyone eavesdropping is that we are not trained to talk to children about money, about finances. Kadalasan, I was talking to a mother and I said, do you actually talk to your daughter about money? Naku boy, hindi pa niyan maiintindihan. And what a surprise, because one of your books, After Pera, Palago in Workbook, which I'm sure is going to be very helpful. You have Money for Kids, or for Kid, you know, and this is a guide on how we should handle our children with things that have something to do with money.
Right.
How exactly do you talk to a child about money? We will find out the answers when we come back here on Private Conversations.